Guys.
Thanks so much, Neil. We'll be watching. Hello, everyone. Right. I'm Taylor Rigg.
I'm Brian Brenberg.
And I'm Jackie DeAngelis. Welcome to the Big Money Show.
With that in their first paid media campaign, let's bring up what they're saying about the Trump-Vance ticket. Here you go. They're running on an extreme, the most future-looking candidate in this entire race right now. And millennials in particular look at J.D. Vance and they say, there we are.
You know,
somebody represents us here.
We're not even. Was a child of Indian immigrants,
right,
and also has a successful law career in her own right. He is a very, and by the way, he's a freshman senator. He has a very, incredible story. Mm-hmm. He had to overcome a lot to get there.
Right.
And instead of focusing on that for one moment to talk about the man behind it, now we have to make him an extremist. And we've got to go back to the rhetoric that got us here in the first place.
Yeah. And for me, the rhetoric, Jackie, and also in Ohio, who's trying to make it work on welfare. Venture capitalists are small entrepreneurs who don't have funding anywhere else. Maybe their bank won't give them money. So these entrepreneurs go to venture capitalists to get money, to get funding, to create a new idea, to bring a new product to this country that makes this country great again, that solves a problem that they see. This is an entrepreneur, pro-business, pro-growth candidate that I think is being overlooked.
Well, and think about this for a second. So he's got has the interest of non-woke big labor. Mm-hmm. How many times have those worlds come together around somebody?
Yeah.
Never. He represents something new in America. And I think an America that maybe is tired of the same old candidates are looking at him and saying, somebody's bringing us the future here.
Yeah.
And that, I think, is going to be intensely interesting to a population that's kind of had it with the past.
And they're trying to tarnish his reputation right from the get-go.
Ooh,
as bullseye. I meant crosshairs, because that would be a lot better. Let's focus on him like he's some sort of a target. Mm. Ultimately, this is the kind of language that, again, led to that attempted assassination. And we're sitting here, the president is just not saying, I misspoke, I shouldn't have said that. We're not gonna say that anymore. Instead, he's trying to clean it up, and he's also trying to say, I made a mistake. You are the leader of the free world. This comes back to mental acuity. You don't get to make mistakes with words like that.
Well, he's doing a classic thing, which is he's sort of trying to clean up over here, and he's spilling even more of it over here. And the result is the aisle is messier after he spoke than when he started speaking. His only saving grace on that, I would say, is I don't think anybody paid attention to that interview.
Well, it wasn't the lead, but some
it
of
was
the
not
other
the
networks
lead last,
were.
Yeah.
You know, I would just say, Jackie, we've talked a lot about this, too.
Accountability
of saying, you know what, I said that word, I misspoke.
Right. Yep,
I apologize.
Sorry.
Shame on me. We all have to do better, including me. The buck stops with me. And I think, you know, maybe people on the right feel like that wasn't a real apology and they're not really getting that accountability. As you mentioned, we're not even 72 hours out.
It wasn't even a backhanded apology.
Out of the way to say, you know, I'm really not focused on the southern
right.
border. I'm worried about doing things to discourage people from coming from Guatemala, Honduras, and Nicaragua. Well, they're coming from the world, including China.
Yeah.
And we better have the resources on the border to stop it. Or we're gonna have more moments of regret like we've had in the last few days with terrible incidents involving brutal murders and rapes and the continuing struggle of communities across the border.
Yeah, she was the border czar, Carl. She had one opportunity to do something, and this is what she did. So instead of attacking J.D. Vance, who hasn't even had a chance yet, maybe the Democrats could do some internal soul searching, which they will never do. Carl Rove, always great to see you. Thank you.
Thanks for having me.
That's the news with the banks. I want to bring you a quick Fox Business alert.
When it hits Congress.
That's good, because as a former econ professor, I will tell you, rent control is stupid. Edward Lawrence, great stuff.
Yeah.
I was just going to say, aren't you like the economic? I mean, basic supply and demand. Even UBS had a note out on this, you guys. If you're a developer, capital seeks the highest risk-adjusted return. If I'm a developer and my rents are capped, why would I deploy my capital there? I'm going to put it elsewhere where I get money. I'm not going to build if my rents are capped. It just doesn't make sense. The solution is more supply, is what UBS is saying, and that seems like common sense.
And that's free markets and allowing rent increases to keep up with the fact that goods and services are increasing too, and landlords have an obligation to keep their properties at a certain level. They can't do that if the rent increases are capped at 5%. So to me, this is another form of economic socialism where they're telling the landlord that he has to subsidize those people who are living in the unit, and that is not sustainable.
Doesn't work.
If you want to go someplace and see failed policy, go to a rent control city and see it in spades.
Meanwhile, we're taking a look at further with business acumen in D.C. Gary, thank you so much.
Thank you. Effectively, then he should be gone. He should be gone.
Appreciate the comments and the time you're spending with us today, Charles. Thank you.
Thank you.
We also want to check on these markets, you guys, because look at these major averages. You're looking at what is going to be the 39th record for the S&P 500, and the Russell 2000 is also getting a big boost. And Jackie, I did the Dow for you, up almost 600 points. Why? Because pretty much United Healthcare is why, right? Investors are really happy that it's February cyber attack. It didn't drive up costs as much as they thought. So a big sigh of relief here from investors. Take a look at Match Group. That is the dating app. They're on pace for one of the biggest jumps we haven't seen in more than a year. This is after the activist investor Starboard said they have an almost 7% stake in the company. Starboard is calling on the company to make improvements or go private. Investors like that.
Is this one of the swiping dating apps, or is this a different
one? They're all swiping.
They're all swiping.
You swipe
it
all. I'm a little out of the game, so I don't quite know which ones you swipe on.
This is the owner of Tinder.
Oh, that's a swiper one.
Yeah.
I think
big time.
I've never been on Tinder. I used to be on Match maybe 100 years ago, and you swipe, I think. But I've been out of the game for a while. Maybe TMI for our audience. Let's take a look and save myself and go to Amazon. Prime Day is kicking off, you guys. So here are some of the great deals that I found. I'm taking the 40% off the Carnival Cruise.
Oh.
Brian, you have a Nerf dart that you can get 40% on sale.
You thought of a Nerf dart for me?
A Nerf dart.
I get that.
40% off.
That.
I'm a Nerf dart.
Run around.
Maybe I'm okay with that.
With your kids.
At the cabin, outside.
Okay, I'm here. I'm with you.
Then I have a good one for Jackie. You're our fiscally prudent girl.
Yes.
You hate going to Starbucks.
That's
it's
true.
A waste of money. There is an espresso machine for $200 off. Skip the line at Starbucks. Make your coffee at home.
Well, how much is it after you take the $200
It's still
off?
Like a couple $100.
Okay. Well, Starbucks gave me a free voucher because Thursday is my birthday. So I will go to Starbucks on Thursday.
No kidding.
Happy early birthday.
Thank you.
Wait, how did you get a voucher? I never got a voucher on my birthday.
From the app.
Oh, you have to have the app. Yeah.
That one's not a swiping app, though.
That is not a swipe app? Thanks for clearing that up. I appreciate it.
Let's get to what's coming up.
Okay, please.
Trump's classified documents. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Good to see you guys.
All right, be sure.
When the Trump reflation trade took hold. And you're really starting to see that as people are hoping on an economic business pro-growth election.
But it's driven by lower interest rates and the idea of tariffs, maybe without, we don't know. But that's kind of the thesis behind the rotation into the Russell.
Cutting regulation.
There's also some lower rates. Jay Powell spoke yesterday. He's hinting maybe not the July cut, but markets are now pricing in a 100% cut in September. And so I think markets are also excited about that.
Speaking of money, switching gears though a little bit, Musk tweeted with a meme and called it fake news. Now, that's very unclear and cryptic in Musk fashion.
Because we don't know which part is fake, right?
If the whole thing is fake, if part of it is fake, the date, the number, can't 100% be sure. But let's say that it were true. I would disagree with Jason and say 20 and glue and having business leaders and people like Elon Musk get behind you with donations like this. Right after the assassination attempt, you had Musk say, I'm putting my full support in. You had Bill Ackman say, I'm endorsing President Trump. I think it's really important and speaks volumes.
ex-supporters of Elon were out in full force on the announcement, effectively saying he spent $44 billion just to bring us. And it's amazing that he'll now reportedly spend $45 million a month to also bring free speech back to the White House. So the supporters on X are very excited.
Yeah, cares about it.
A guy who's going to shell out like that for free speech, I'm not concerned that he thinks he's going to buy with $45 million like some kind of control over Trump. That's not his game.
We did the math. What is it? Something like $100 million if it was going to November. He's got plenty of money. As you mentioned, the Twitter acquisition tells us that.
Great chat. Making money with Charles Payne starts now.
All righty. Thank you very much and good afternoon.